हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल माइंड मिथ मोमेंटस। इन टुडेज एपिसोड ऑफ द सीरीज मेंटल हेल्थ मैटर्स वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड मेंटल वेलबींग एंड परफॉर्मेंस। हाउ मेंटल वेलबींग अफेक्ट द वर्क। वी स्पेंड मोर टाइम फॉर वर्क रादर देन फॉर होम। एट वर्क प्लेस मोस्टली द पीपल नीड टू टॉक अबाउट टास्क एंड डेडलाइंस मोर देन फीलिंग्स, बट एट टाइम्स leaving aside the task and deadline discussions, open discussion on mental stress and issues and its resolutions becomes important and mandatory if we have to get the required output and productivity, or else limitation sets in. Some of those possible work performance limitations can be an inability to screen out environmental stimuli or an inability to concentrate. A person could experience a lack of stamina and difficulty handling time pressures or multiple tasks. They could also have a problem handling negative feedback or in responding to change. Mental health problems also have an impact on employers and businesses directly through increased absenteeism, negative impact on productivity and profits, as well as an increase in cost to deal with the issue. In addition, they impact employee morale adversely. Why well-being is important at workplace? Employee well-being can directly improve the mental and physical health of the workforce, with general health being linked to the levels of productivity. A healthier and happier workforce is more productive workforce. In hard statistics, mental health impacts your bottom line. A happy workforce is a productive workforce. Less absence and lower staff turnover equals less cost to your business. And higher productivity with pride in the quality of work leads to higher quality products or services. By improving the health and well-being of your people, you are not only improving their quality of life, but you are helping to create a more motivated, engaged and high-performing workforce, resulting in a greater organizational success. Well-being of an employee. Studies show that employees that are in good state of mental well-being are most commonly the employees that have a greater job performance. Here, the impact wellness has on a person's mental capabilities, motivation and overall health is clear. Voluntary performance is increased by improving mental well-being. Improved mental well-being means higher morale, that is more positive emotions, less distress and higher job satisfaction. Job satisfaction is the judgment the employee makes about their work by weighing up their positive and negative experiences. Let's understand it better by taking an example of the educator. As educator's well-being is a positive emotional state that combines the personal needs and expectations of both learners and the educators, educator well-being and job satisfaction strongly influence educators' behavior and are positively related to school and classroom climate and pupil achievement. The impact of educator's well-being on performance. An individual's perception about their abilities assist in their happiness. Self-efficacy is the extent to which an individual feels able to complete tasks and reach goals. Being self-efficacious is similar to thinking with a growth mindset. It's also essential to happiness and to the sense of well-being. Teacher's self-efficacy correlates with improved students' outcomes more so than subject knowledge and personality. An educator with a strong sense of self-efficacy is more likely to feel confident in choosing the best approach to suit the needs of their classroom, be adaptable and resilient when faced with the challenge or change, engage in inquiry and research in their own classroom and feel secure enough to share this with others, feel able to work collaboratively and contribute to building a knowledge-creating profession. Statistics for educators' mental health. According to the latest research, 75% of all education staff have faced mental health issues in the last 2 years because of their work. And 53% have considered leaving as a result. Almost 1 in 5 had experienced panic attacks. Over half had suffered from insomnia and difficulties sleeping. Over a third had experienced difficulty concentrating. Nearly half had suffered for their personal life. Over a quarter had been forced to take time off work for family. Of these, half had been off for more than 15 days in a year during the academic session. Workload and work-life balance were cited as the top work-related reasons. Symptoms and issues suffered appearing similar across roles and levels of seniority. Employee mental well-being. As workplaces and organizations are social entities in which employees interact, the level of mental well-being of staff A may well affect the level of mental well-being of staff B. And so, employees' mental well-being can affect workplace performance not only through its potential effect on the staff's own output, but also through its potential. Feelings of well-being are fundamental to the overall health of an individual, enabling them to successfully overcome difficulties and achieve what they want out of life. Past experiences, attitudes, and outlook can all impact well-being, as can physical or emotional trauma following specific incidents. Fostering employee mental and physical well-being is good for people and the organization. Promoting well-being can help prevent stress and create positive working environments where individuals and organizations can thrive. Good mental and physical health and well-being can be a core enabler of employee engagement and organizational performance. Better output and productivity makes us feel satisfied and good. Regardless of the definition, being happy makes you feel spectacular. It can boost your productivity, which in turn will make you more successful. Actually, productivity and happiness goes both ways. Productivity makes you feel satisfied and happy, and when you are happy, you are more productive. Some of the reasons for so are: productivity gives you purpose. Having a purpose in your life gives you the reason to get up every morning. And when you achieve a goal, your self-esteem increases. Striving towards something gives you positivity, energy, focus, and conviction. People who lack this direction are rarely happy. Productivity lifts your mood. That is, whether mental or physical, checking off your to-do list or visiting the health club, the more productive you are, the more motivated you tend to feel. Productivity helps you grow. It motivates you to challenge yourself, developing your skills and informing a more well-rounded approach to tasks and interactions. Forward-moving path makes you grow constantly, even if you can't feel it in the movement. The surprising signs of happiness. We have within us the capacity to manufacture the happiness we are constantly chasing. The two types of happiness are natural happiness, that is, what we get when we get what we wanted, and synthetic happiness, that is, what we make when we don't get what we wanted. We are actually happier when we don't have a choice and accept our situation. Happiness and productivity. A recent study by economists around the globe has found that happiness leads to a 12% to 13% spike in productivity, while unhappy workers proved 10% less productive. Hence, it is known that human happiness has large and positive causal effects on productivity. Some studies have shown that happy employees have higher level of creativity than unhappy ones. Being happy can free up the brain, allowing for increased mental flexibility and imaginations. And happy people are more healthier. Hence, better the mental well-being, happier the employee. Happier the employee, happiness into work. Happy workings, that is, better productivity. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, share, subscribe the channel M3, that is Mind Myth Momentous. In the next episode, we will try to understand 7 principles that fuel success and performance at work. Till then, bye.